MO2 versus Vortex. Vortex was introduced back in 2018 with the idea of creating a new replacement for Nexus Mods Manager. Nexus Mod Manager had become relatively outdated and people had started to move across to Mod Organizer, developed by the creator Tannin. So 2018, Tannin was taken on board by Nexus Mods to create Vortex. Their idea was to create a more modern and sleek user experience for their Mod Manager. And credit where it's due, they achieved it. Vortex has a very modern and crisp design to it, with a simple integration of Nexus Mods, providing plenty of support for you to start your modding journey. Vortex also provides support for a large number of games. Mod Organizer 2 was released back in the release of Skyrim Special Edition in 2016. When Tannin retired from Mod Organizer, he made the program open source. A team of developers then took on Mod Organizer and improved it up to today's standards, thereby creating Mod Organizer 2. This Mod Organizer was perfectly designed to work well with Bethesda titles such as Fallout and Skyrim. Very experienced team members dedicated to the application itself. And this matters. It seems like a bizarre statement, but you're involved in something that you're not financially compensated for, at least not directly. Your interest must be heavily invested in the application itself. Now, MO2 is not promoted in the same way Vortex is. Where Vortex has Nexus Mods to officially promote it, MO2 relies on word of mouth. Now, if you're looking to add a couple of mods and just get started, Vortex might be ideally suited for you, taking a lot of the work away from the initial setup so you don't have to invest quite as much in getting started. Now, if you're yet to experience Mod Manager at all, MO2 might appear to be a bit of an overkill. There is a lot of information to take in straight away, which might put you off before you even get started. Now, Vortex comes with a few caveats. Firstly, the development. Now, the application has quite an aggressive advertising campaign for Nexus Mods Premium. Similar to their website, it's promoted at every opportunity they can, and it gets rather intrusive. Now, advertising does keep many afloat, and it is great to be supported for your work. But in this case, cutting into your display window with an advert for it can start to make navigation a little trickier. The application itself feels like it's specifically designed with new modders in mind, which is perfect in so many ways for those starting out. But as you want to grow your list of mods, you might find that Vortex will present a few challenges for you. I've seen quite a number of comments of people struggling to use Vortex as they've grown their mod builds. An example of this would be down to their load order, which uses a rule system, and their hard link deployment, which we'll touch on in a moment. Now, if you run Vortex on the side along with another mod manager, for example, Vortex automatically assigns itself to handle NXM links. This is another point that ties in with their aggressive marketing strategy. I don't believe it should be able to do that without actually prompting or asking you to do so first, because then if you want to use MO2 or another one for something else, you have to go back into the application and reprioritize that one. And it's the same with the extensions, automatically installed inside Vortex for games that you might not have any interest in playing. Having extra files and bits installed without you understanding why they're installed or if you need them means you have to actively remove them if you don't need them there. Ideally, you want to start with nothing and build your way up. That way, you understand what it is you're installing, why you're installing it, and if you need it or not. So let's compare some of the key elements of both of these. We'll start with layout. Upon opening Vortex, you're greeted with a colorful menu and a few points on how to get started. A simple layout ideal for first-time modders. It'll guide you through the initial steps that need to be taken. You can already see the attraction for those who don't know where to begin. With so many different elements to think about, any help is very much appreciated. So you click to add your game, you navigate through the list, and job done. Not a bad start. With a way of integrating your Nexus Mods profile directly into your mod manager, allowing you to download directly to Vortex, it's never been easier. Now, Vortex does provide the option to customize your dashboard, change things around, and set things up according to your own personal preferences. However, you can't remove the Go Premium section. Makes sense. It's in their best interest to promote their own product. But the lack of control over the layout in that respect, along with a banner across the top of the window to start with, shows that they're almost more invested in their own financial benefit than your user experience. This is continued on the downloads page with a bright blue text box that says that downloads are capped unless you pay for premium. I think by this point, we start to get the idea. Marketing aside, The layout is fantastic. Smart, simple, and functional. It provides a great starting point for those new to modding. Everything very clearly labeled and divided up into sections. For those looking to modify multiple games, there's a section for that too. When opening MO2, you're immediately greeted with the main screen. There isn't the same progressive windows or tutorials as there is with Vortex, and for new modders that might be a little overwhelming at first, but if you take a moment to break it down, it's actually not as scary as it looks. The design is made to function. All the information and areas you need access to are clearly presented to you, with navigation made as simple as possible. Forget welcome menus and pop-ups, MO2 gets straight to the point. MO2's main window provides a table containing all the information about each mod that you will need to know, with the names, conflicts, categories, and version numbers. The icons at the top give you access to your settings, your profiles, and the abilities to add and remove mods. This drop-down box will show you the applications installed for your game. Now, MO2 do provide a few customization options, so you can change the design of the layout as you see fit. This includes different themes, which allows you to switch from light to dark mode. For someone like me, dark mode is very much appreciated. Staring at the screen all day, it starts to take it out on your eyes.
Is that so?
Mod conflicts. Naturally, the aim for both of these managers is going to be to resolve conflicts that arise. So is there a difference in the way that these two mod managers handle them? Now, Vortex uses a rule system. This built-in tool allows it to spot conflicts for you, prompt you to decide which of the two it is that you want to choose, and you then just make the decision. Very simple, straightforward, and easy to use. The problem is, choosing how to structure your mod priority and load order isn't always as simple as choosing A or B. It's actually closer to a list, and if you don't have the opportunity to structure that list, you might find that choosing one or the other doesn't actually solve the problem at all. Now, MO2 has a slightly different approach here. Problems with your load order will be flagged in your main window, brought to your attention so that you can address them, but it won't fix them for you. It'll just notify you. You have to make those changes to make that work. But with MO2, it really is as simple as dragging and dropping. You can move the mods around as you need, and MO2 will apply those changes to your mod list. Updates. Mods are updated all the time, as are the games, and it's a modder's nightmare. A single update can throw everything off. As for handling the updates, Vortex has you covered at a click of a button. Lets you know that a mod has been updated, you can then select and update that mod, thanks to its integration with Nexus Mods. Now, that's a very useful feature for Vortex. MO2 hasn't got the same edge as such, it won't automatically update them, but it will flag them for you. It'll let you know that a mod version is outdated based on the information that it retrieves from the Nexus Mods site. Deployment. Deployment is how those mods are implemented into the game. The mod manager will take all the information you need, all the mod files and key bits of data, and it will give it to the game to load in. Now, if this is done incorrectly, you can end up messing with the actual game files, which can cause crashes or problems, corruptions, all kind of things which you want to avoid. Now, Vortex uses what is known as a hardlink deployment. It essentially creates a dummy file in the game directory, allowing the game to be run without loading Vortex first. Even with dummy files, it's still adding and removing from the game directory itself. And the more that you decide to change your mod list, the more times it's contacting and removing information from the game directory. And ideally, you'll want to reduce that as much as possible. Now, there seems to be a bit of a misunderstanding with Vortex deployment. A lot of people think that a hardlink deployment means that the files are actually put into the game directory itself directly. This is not the case. It still actually keeps the mod files separate from the game directory. Now, with the dummy files that it puts into the game directory, it links it back to the main files on Vortex. Now, Vortex does have a purge option which removes all of these dummy files from the game directory. The problem is, it's not always 100% secure. As soon as you start manipulating data and adding and removing, it's not always guaranteed that any purging is going to remove all of the information and the things that were changed. Now, Vortex did have a virtual deployment system in development created by Talon himself. However, it appears it hasn't been updated since 2021. And with Vortex designed for a large number of games, they're going to be looking at the bigger picture, not specifically for Bethesda games, where a virtual file system is more preferable. Mod Organizer 2 uses a virtual file system. This means it leaves the game directory untouched. and nothing goes into the game directory itself. Now, this is preferred when it comes to larger builds or those who constantly make changes to their mod list, as your game directory is not at risk of corrupted files from adding and removing data all the time. Now, this does mean there's more processes taking place behind the scenes, which means the loading times will take a little bit longer as it has to reach out to different directories to get the information it needs. A common misunderstanding with MO2's deployment is that it uses something called a soft link. If Vortex uses hard links, it's easy to assume that MO2 uses soft links, the alternate. However, that's not the case. Soft link seems to be a term derived from symlinks, which is a completely different method. The term soft link seems to be a misunderstanding. The key points to take away would be this. Vortex. Ideally suited for first-time modders, Vortex will guide you through the initial steps. Vortex is great for managing a number of games outside of Skyrim itself. Its user interface is clean, modern, and easy to use. The way that they've implemented a rule system to handle mod conflicts is great for those new to it. But as you grow that list, that's going to be problematic. It's clear that Vortex have tried and succeeded at creating a mod manager aimed at those new to modding. A perfect way to guide you through the initial steps, taking as much of the work off of you as possible. MO2, it's a workhorse. The perfect choice for those with large mod lists or complex builds. It provides you with complete control over your modding experience, including your load order and mod priority. And it uses a deployment method that keeps the game directory spick and span. MO2 is built with the main intention of handling Bethesda games, which can't be modded in ways that other games can. Rather than it being made to appeal to those brand new to modding, its design is to be as functional as possible. It's a smart choice for those looking to install a large number of mods. Bottom line here, it comes down to personal preference. Which that is, I'll leave that up to you. Perfect time for a brew.